Right now, we are joined by the head coach of those San Diego State Aztecs as he gets ready for the Utah Utes, Steve Fisher. Coach, it's great to see you. Thank you for the time. How are you?
Gentlemen, I'm doing great, thank you. How are you guys?
Doing well, Coach.
Very well.
Gerard, you're bundled up like it's like you're back east,
you
man.
Know, Coach, I'm getting soft right now. I'm used to this warm weather. I live out in Rancho Bernardo where it's warm all the time, so now I get a little bit of breeze, and I'm a little frosty. I'm not going to lie.
I'm 12 years here, and I'm promised never, ever to complain, so I'm not.
There you go. Coach, last week we had one of your former players on, Juwan Howard. And he talked about not only his memories playing for you, but how to this day he's in touch, he follows your program, and he understands the relationship that you have with these players. It goes way beyond sports. Is that one of your major philosophies, that this is not just a basketball program, but this is a family you're building?
I think if you're in this business, there's a whole lot more than winning and losing. And yet if you don't win, you're not going to be around very long. So you have to find a way to win. And but it's about relationships, and it's not, you know, Juwan is one of our marquee superstars, but we have that same relationship with former managers and players that didn't start and didn't play as much as others, and that's what it's about, really. You help them when you can, and vice versa. Juwan is one of the best ever, though, that we've ever come across, and he probably told you, he comes out here every year. And we get together as families and with the Dutchers, who he's still very, very close with.
How cool.
So it's very cool.
Coach, also he spoke about how when recruiting, some guys came and spoke to him about, you can have this, you can have that, you can be the next guy. You went right to his family and appealed to his grandmother. And I thought that was just brilliant as a recruiter. Is that what you look to do? You tell people, listen, it's more than basketball, it's about the family. And I want to let you know that your boy, by the time he's done, will be a man when he leaves my school.
You try to be honest, you try to be real, you try to do all those things, and you try to reach the people that are important in each of the relationships in terms of the recruiting. With Juwan, as you guys both know, it was his grandmother. He was raised by his grandmother, who tragically had a heart attack and died the morning that he signed his national letter of intent. But she instilled all those qualities in him that you see in him now. I remember vividly, he would iron his blue jeans before he would go out. He took that much pride in who he was. So you try to do that with the relationships with families and say, I've got two sons of my own, and I know what it's like, and we will do right by them. They won't like what they hear all the time, but we will do what's in their best interest.
Coach Fisher is with us before the Utah game. Yeah, I realize you have expectations. You have a vision before every season, but as a fan, this is exceeding my expectations. I never said number 6 in the nation, 23-1. Are there times this year when you look around Viejas Arena, and although you can envision success, has any of this exceeded your expectations?
I don't think any of us thought we would start the season 20-0. I don't know that we envisioned we would be rated 4th, 5th, 6th in the country, but we knew we were going to be good. So we talked about before the season started, Josh and Sherrod, about dreams and dream, and for our players to dream big, that we could do something special. We talked about that, and we still talk about it.
When you were coming down, I saw you walking down the steps. As you get here, the fans are going crazy. They're giving you high fives. They're taking pictures. You're absolutely taking your time to do that. So I have to imagine in your thoughts that's important for the fans to realize just how important they are to the actual team.
They have been so instrumental and invaluable in helping us be successful and win. There's absolutely no question on that. We have turned Viejas Arena into one of the best home courts in the country. And it's created by our fans and the atmosphere. But it's fun to be here, too. You don't have to be a 20-year-old college student to come here and enjoy the atmosphere in the moment. And everything, everybody is a part of it.
Absolutely. Coach Steve Fisher, in his 12th season with the Aztecs, getting ready for Utah tonight. Coach, a nice piece in the UT today by Mark Ziegler when he said, Coach Fisher has never been a conference coach of the year, and he doesn't care about that type of stuff. But even though you may not care about it, do you ever think about it during seasons like this? Do you ever think about that kind of accolade?
No. I mean, I told our players, and I told Ziegler this as he was writing the article. I haven't seen it yet. I said, we preach team. And we downplay individual awards, and which is why I haven't made a big deal out of Kawhi being Player of the Week 5 or 6 times. And the same thing with DJ. But we talked to our team on Friday about, DJ making the final cut for the Bob Cousy Award,
yep,
in the final 10, and Kawhi being co-player of the week again. It only happens because your team is successful. So I use this verbiage, when the team wins, everybody's boat rises a little bit, and mine included. I'm smart enough to know that. So, but I would much rather win 7 straight conference games here than any individual awards for myself or for our players.
Coach, 12th year into this thing here with San Diego State. Obviously, you've not the spring chicken. You've been around the block a number of times. You've been in this basketball game for a good long while. How do you gauge when you at what point during the year in the offseason do you look at and say, okay, I feel it now and I know I want to come back? Because doing it for a good long while, after a while, does it get a little tiresome? Does it wear down on you? At what point of the year do you say, I feel it now, I know I want to be here, and let's move on for the next year?
If this is too much like a job for any of us, then you won't survive in it, whether you're 3 years in the business or 43 years. You have to love what you're doing, and you can't be punching the clock. And yet, at times, everything that all of us do, yourselves included, it gets hard. It gets hard. Some days are harder than others, but I have had the perspective, and I now have the age with me, that I can appreciate what I've got, where I am, who I'm with, what I'm doing, the people who are here. So I'm having the time of my life, and, I'm planning on staying here a while longer. How much longer? I don't know, but right now I feel good. I'm healthy. We've got a good team, good program, and it's fun, and you have to treat it that way. I separate the office from home. When I go home, we rarely talk about talk shop about what happened at the office, and I think that's important also.
Does your son have the same aspirations, same exact, as you when you were that age?
Mark, our older son, is on staff with us, and he's always been a gym rat. He's always been a guy that hung around and played and wanted to do what I'm doing. So, yes, I would say so. My dad was my first coach. He couldn't make a living at it, so he had to work and couldn't do what he loved, which was coaching. So Mark has done a wonderful job for us. I'm very proud of him, and we're excited that, as a family, that we've got him on staff also.
Coach, now that your players are getting close to the finish line, at least of the regular season, conference tournaments coming up, NCAA tournaments coming up, what's their mindset? Where does your team stand at this point physically? I know you had some injuries, just mentally, emotionally, the grind of the season, all the success. Where's their mind at this point of the season?
I talked about being ready to play and not when you walk out for the opening tip. You have to prepare yourself long before that. And I could see that even before the game that I was a little worried about TCU, that we didn't have quite, and I use the phrase, we weren't quite on edge enough. And it doesn't take much. It doesn't take much to where you can come up and get slapped by anybody. So we've preached that. We've talked that. We've shortened our practices. We've got to make sure that we save legs and that mentally we are sharp. And that's your point. That is maybe the most important thing now, the mental approach to the game. We know when they're physically drained, but they have to stay sharp mentally, and we have to do a good job of helping along that line.
Aztecs looking for win number 24 tonight, number 6 in the nation. He is Steve Fisher. It's going to be another sellout. It will be rocking at Viejas Arena. Coach, always a pleasure. We do appreciate the time. Thank you.
Thank you very much, man. I appreciate it.
Thanks, Coach.
Sherrod, Josh, thank you.